Enjoy.
Hey there.
How you doing?
Pretty good. I have a few questions for you about Wild Bills.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I might put you on the spot on a couple of these, but
okay,
just
no
bear
problem.
With me. As far as the background of your business, I was wondering how you got into making sodas.
Yeah, actually what it was is inspired by my grandfather, who actually was a baker by trade.
Mm-hmm.
And so he was always playing with flavors in his basement just for fun.
Mm-hmm.
And as a kid, we recalled actually going down there and trying some of the flavors, sneaking into his little batch and trying them. So they're traditional flavors that we, from many years ago, but they're the traditional flavors that you don't typically find anymore, like sarsaparilla, birch beer, vanilla cream, we have an orange cream, and we also have diet root beer with a little cream element to it. So we're trying to recreate those recipes and those flavors that we recall from memory. So there's no real recipe per se, but it's inspired and actually recreated from the flavors that we actually recall from our childhood.
Okay, what are some of the ingredients?
Well, we try to stay true as best we can, but a lot of them are actually the roots and so forth, and like birch or sassafras and those things. The vanillas and everything, we try to stay as true as we can to those flavors without using too much of the artificial flavorings.
Mm-hmm.
So they're not organic, but we try to go ahead and we do actually use pure cane sugar as opposed to fructose, so we can maintain a higher integrity of product.
Mm-hmm.
Also, with all the issues now surrounding fructose, we find that it's actually much better to be using pure cane sugar, and that's really what the customer wants to.
Mm-hmm. What is the difference between old-fashioned soda and modern soda?
Well, the fructose is sweeteners, okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's cheaper, it's easier to manufacture with, and cheaper actually to manufacture with fructose opposed to sugar.
Mm-hmm.
So the first thing is the sweetener. So we try to stay true to the old flavors that actually use sugar. So that actually provides a better taste, a deeper flavor, richer flavor. Also, we use less carbonation. The Cokes and the Pepsis or the Colas and so forth use a high carbonation level, which actually doesn't keep the flavor on the tongue as long and fizzes off quick. So we try to go and we try to deaden the carbonation or lower it.
Mm-hmm.
So you get a richer, smoother flavor and it stays on the palate better.
Mm-hmm. How did you name Wild Bill's?
Well, actually, it was just me and my brother who originally started the company.
Mm-hmm.
My grandfather's name isn't Bill or anything like that, but what we want to do is actually create that mystique that we feel transcends much of Americana, that everyone can relate to. And of course, growing up as kids, I think we all wanted to be cowboys at one point in time. So it was one of those things where we just had fun with it, and we really liked the Western motif, and we took that name.
How about, I was wondering, what was the Mushroom Festival like yesterday?
The Mushroom Festival was great. It was a tent. It was really what the Mushroom Festival, what they designed it to be.
Mm-hmm.
It was crowded, beautiful weather and everything. And, of course, good weather and, a hot hot day actually is great for us.
Yeah.
So we did really well. We were busy all day long. This year we have two stands here, and we knocked it out of the park. So we did really well. And they've been really good to us, so we appreciate it.
Are you working on any other new flavors?
We've been getting a lot of requests. We want to come out with an orange, a dyed orange, with our flavor. Also a ginger ale and a cherry. So we're thinking about doing a Wishniac cherry.
Ah, how about a ginger beer?
You know what? That's actually, when everyone says ginger ale, I actually want to do a ginger beer.
Mm-hmm.
So that's actually one of my, it's a very unique flavor. It's different. It's not as common. And that's really what we want to do is be different and unique. So I think that's a flavor we'll also look to do.
When you were a kid growing up, did you have a favorite soda?
Orange. And the reason is we only got orange if we won the baseball game.
Oh.
So it's one of those things, if you worked hard and you succeeded, you got that. So,
yeah.
And that's really where all these flavors come from. It's all those memories that you have as a child or wherever that you actually look back to. So it's actually it's an experiential type of thing. It brings back memories.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't by design. It was by accident. It's what we hear from everyone else.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what actually I remember. So.
Yeah. What kind of ice cream is the best kind of ice cream for a root beer float?
Any. It's actually personal preference, but vanilla you can't beat. So,
yeah.
They actually, everyone talks about how we should have ice cream served as a side item, but it's less is more, and I could see someone tripping on the plug, and then we'd have melted ice cream. So it'd work well for a short time, but we'd probably mess it up.
Yeah.
We want to do one thing, do it well. That's a soda.
What are your flavors, and do you have a favorite one of them?
We have seven flavors. We have the Rocky Mountain Root Beer. We have the Diet Rocky Mountain Root Beer. Mm-hmm. We have the Buck and Birch. We have the Six Shooter Sarsaparilla. Mm-hmm. The Vintage Vanilla Cream. The Outlaw Orange, and the Gatling Gun Grape. And
I like your names.
I know. It's actually, they're all kind of have a little twist to them. But my favorite's actually the cream.
Okay.
So it's kind of weird. It's, the most popular ones, though, are the Rocky Mountain Root Beer and the Vanilla Cream.
How do you design a flavor?
It basically comes to, it started with us, like how we, what we really wanted to see a little bit more often that you don't see so often in the stores. Mm-hmm. You go to the convenience store or wherever and you have a wall of selections through all the ginseng and, you know, the all energy drinks and everything. So really we look to kind of capture those flavors that we didn't find as readily available. So it's really trying to be unique and different. And then, of course, the personal preferences.
Okay, I mean the actual, like, taste testing. And, how do you decide, like, when it's finished or, like, which one?
We're not in the basement boiling pots of stew and everything. But we actually have a flavorist that works with us in creating these flavors. And like I said, we don't really have a recipe that we go after. Or we're going off of, we actually go from memory. So we're asking and telling them exactly what we're looking for, and they modify each of the samples, and we go ahead and do several taste tests and try our, you know, have our families and friends try them out, and then we kind of just take a vote. And as long as they can, and they work really well with us. So we're thinking about coming out with like a pumpkin flavor, because we do some pumpkin events, all these festivals. I don't think we'll do a mushroom one soon, but we'll probably get creative too and do some fun stuff.
How did you decide on what kind of bottle to use?
Actually, the bottle is a big deal, believe it or not. Mm-hmm. And what I found in bottling, and like we found out, is doing it backwards for any other beverage company. We're actually marketing through events and festivals, and we're creating the demand for actually bottles. So the bottles are coming secondary, where typically a beverage company comes out with a bottle product first and tries to build the market. We're doing it backwards, so hopefully it'll be the success, not the failure. But in finding a bottle, we wanted a traditional bottle, one that is not typical that you find, that you see, you know, in the stores. And in doing so, it's very difficult because the glass market dictates to the fillers what's available. So you can't just go to a showroom and say, I want a trailer of that, a trailer of this. They might ask what you want, but they'll say, that's fine, but you'll get this. So it's really difficult to find the right bottle that captures the essence, the look, and the feel of what you're trying to bring to the market. So we've just actually found our supply just last week, so that's a very...
Congratulations.
Yeah, that's actually a very interesting question. Timing on that, actually.
Yeah.
So yeah. Mm. So it's a traditional bottle, really cool, really unique. Hope everyone likes it.
Cool. Do you by any chance have a sample of that, a bottle on you?
I do not.
Oh, and man.
I apologize, because actually the bottle product is better than here, only because you have a lot of elements, environmental elements that play into the making of it. But our website, wildbillsoda.com, we have the samples there and everything, you mail order and so forth. But I apologize. Typically, I do.
Okay.
This has been a tough show.
Do you have any other festivals this year coming up?
Yeah, we have a whole bunch. In fact, this is our busy season. We have a lot of bike weeks coming up. Next week, we have the Delmarva Bike Week. We also have an auto show up in Massachusetts. We do the Pumpkin Chunkin' down in Delaware. And we do a lot of big events, the Jack Daniels barbecue event. And we're doing a lot of events that you can find on our website as far as the schedule and the dates and the names of those events and their locations.
Okay. Okay, one last question. What is the worst thing someone could say about you?
About me or the product?
I told you I was going to ask you some hard questions.
Okay, all right.
That's going to put you on the spot. If you don't,
No. Actually, a lot of the problems we have doing these events, okay, is that a lot of the vendors really get upset with how well we do because we do so well with the soda and we hurt their sales. So the worst thing that typically hear that we hear is that we take their business away, and we. I apologize to an extent, but.
Yeah. Okay, well.
A personal thing, if people say I'm too tall sometimes.
Okay, cool. Well, hey, thanks so much.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it.
Yeah.